Remembrance Sunday, what it means to me personally is it's the time that the nation comes together to remember its fallen. And it's not just the fallen of the Great War, the Second World War, and all the other conflicts after that, but it's the fallen of today. A lot of people believe that the poppy appeal is only there to support the old from many years ago. It's not. It's there to support all serving and ex-serving members of the Majesty's Armed Forces and their dependents. And this is a key issue that people tend to forget. If a soldier is lost, be it a male or a female, their dependents are entitled to the support of the Royal British Legion, and that's what we're here to do. The service this morning will be conducted. It's a service that we designed this service probably about 30 years ago. And this morning, first of all, the parade will be marched on by the parade commander, who this year is commanded by a petty officer from the Sea Cadet Corps. He will march the parade on. Once he's marched the parade on, he will then bring the parade to attention and he will march on the standards of all the ex-service organisations. Once they have taken their place, then I will escort the mayor and the council officers down to the war memorial. Today is something slightly different because we have a new name that has been added to the war memorial this year. So before the start of the service, the war memorial must be re-blessed. And that will just take about a few moments, but you must obviously have the service blessed.
It's helping his regiment to move parts of an enormous turbine to a new dam to generate electricity for a large part of the Helmand province in Afghanistan. He stepped onto a bomb left by the Taliban and was killed on the 13th of September, only a few months ago.
Once that's been conducted, there will be a hymn, a few prayers, and then we will go into the act of remembrance. And the act of remembrance is where we say the exaltation and we say the communion. There will be the laying of the wreaths. Once the wreaths have been laid and the lowering of the Union flag, then there will be a march past and the organisation will obviously march past the mayor, of which this year I will be taking this salute.
Today is very important for everyone in the United Kingdom. They need to pause and reflect and commemorate those who've made great sacrifices in the conflicts of the 20th century, World War I and World War II in particular, but also in subsequent conflicts, Falklands and, of course, currently Iraq and Afghanistan. And we reflected here in Gray's Thurrock very much on Nicky Mason, the brave paratrooper who lost his life 2 months ago, a man of Thurrock. So we remember him. We're also very proud to have the wonderful Gurkhas marching here this morning. They recently lost one of their colleagues in Afghanistan, so we particularly reflect upon their courage, their service to the United Kingdom over two centuries. This was one of the best parades I've attended in the 17 years I've been a Member of Parliament. People are turning out. There's now a great interest in commemorating these events to acknowledge and salute the brave men and women who've fought on behalf of the Crown. And last but not least, of course, we mark this week the 90th anniversary of the armistice of World War I. And I think that school children, students are particularly focusing on the significance of that conflict, both from a military and political point of view, but also from a social point of view. Remember, what emerged from World War I in particular was women's suffrage. It's an event which we should not take for granted. It was an extension of our democracy, and that suffrage, that right to vote, was won by women by their dedication, their service in World War I, which we commemorate this week.